Good morning to all students. Today we start a new topic related to taxonomy of insects. First of all, we start the order Orthoptera. Orthoptera is an order of insect. It means ortho means straight, or tera means wings. Those insects which have straight wings, their fore wings are smaller than the hind wings. Hind wings are more membranous, or the fore wings are leathery or tegmental. Such type of characters are found in this order. General characters of this order: medium to large size insect are present in this order. Head is generally hypognathous. You know very well what you mean by hypognathous, when the mouth parts are directed downwards or right angle to the body. That is hypognathous. Rarely prognathous. Bears a large compound eyes. Normally three ocelli are distinct, but absent in the wingless species, or reduced to two in some long-horned grasshoppers. Antorium is egg-shaped and distinct. You know very well that antorium is endoskeleton of the head. Antennae is filiform in tetragonates, but shorter and more monoliform in short horn grasshoppers. Mouth parts are mandibulate type. The very primitive type of mouth parts are present, in which the all part of mandibulate type means labrum, mandible, maxillae, labium, and hyperbarics. Five segmented maxillary palp or three segmented labial palps are present. Head is broadly articulated to the thorax. Prothorax is large. Pronotum is curved, ventrally covering the pleural region. Pronotum. Extend towards the meso and metathorax, and extended up to the pleural region ventrally. Meso and metathorax is comparatively much shorter. Hind legs are saltatorial. Saltatorial means for the jumping purpose. Mole cricket have the normal hind legs, but fore legs are fossorial. Fossorial means legs are adapted for the digging purpose. Tarsi three or four segmented. Rarely five or two segmented. Insect of Orthoptera are winged Brachypterus or Apterus. Forewings is leathery, thickened, and known as tegmina. They are capable of bending without breaking. Hindwings are membranous with large anal area. विंग्स के बारे में हमने पहले ही सारी चीजें बता दी हैं। ये जितने भी टर्म्स हमने काम में लिए हैं वो हम पहले हेड, थोरैक्स और एब्डोमेन में बता चुके हैं। वो सब चीजें यहाँ टर्म्स काम में आ रहे हैं, आपने पढ़ लिए होंगे। हाइंड विंग्स आर फोल्डेड बाय लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल प्लेट्स बिटवीन विंग्स एंड कैप बीनिथ द टेग्मिना. Means the hind wings are protected from the tegmina. Sarsi are short and unsegmented. Ovipositor is well developed in females. In gallids, the ovipositor is long and needle-like, and In gyrotalpids, ovipositor is wanting or reduced. In many orthoptera, is newly hatched first instar. Nymphs are covered by loose cuticle and are called pronymphs. Wing pads of nymphs undergo the reversal during development. Specialized stridulatory organs. Stridulatory organs are sound producing organs, and auditory organs are the hearing organs, are present in this group. Metamorphosis is slight. Slight metamorphosis, sometimes called the orometabolism, or the insects are present in orthoptera are grasshoppers, locusts, muscatitids, crickets, small crickets, etc. Four major families are included in this group. Number one, family Acinetidae, for the salt-horned grasshoppers and locusts. The members of this family are often destructive to crops and vegetation, means serious pests. Antennae short, tarsus is three-segmented, ovipositor is short and horny, tympani is located on either side of the first abdominal segment, one on either side of the first abdominal segment. Sound is produced, means stridulation, by femur or alary mechanism. Short horned grasshoppers are non-migratory, and locust name is used for migratory. There is Locusta migratoria and Cestostica gregaria. These are the insects which are present in family Acinetidae. Family Catagonidae. Members of this family are long-horned grasshoppers, that is, bush catatids or bush crickets. Insects are winged or wingless forms. When wings present, left tegmina overlap the right one. In males, cubito-anal region of tegmina modified for a stridulation. Antennae is long, slender, as long as or longer than the body. Tarsus is four-segmented. Ovipositor is very long, even exceeding the length of body. Short shape, like or sickle cell. Auditory organs are present in four tibia. In each four tibia, a pair of tympanum is present. Sound production is alary type, and the muscles are vibrate. Sound is produced. Holocora indica or Phasconura viridissima is the example of Tetragonidae, or the long-horned grasshoppers. The third one, family, is Gryllidae. Gryllidae, in which the crickets, house crickets are included in this group. Members of this family having the long antennae, tarsus with three segments, ovipositor is slender and needle-like, forewings are abruptly bent down to cover the sides of body. Hind wings are acuminate. Sarsi are long and unsegmented. Auditory organs are located on the four tibia, and stridulatory organs are similar to the long horned grasshoppers. They produce a shrill chirping noise during night. Gryllus campestris and Acheta domesticus is the example of family Gryllidae. The fourth family is the Gryllotalpidae, in which the mole crickets are included. Mole crickets are brown colored insect found inside the burrows. If they are present in burrows or if they are lived in burrows, their eyes are reduced. Pronotum is elongated, ovate, and rounded posteriorly. Forelegs are fossorial, means adapted for the digging, because they are living in burrows. Tibia are expanded, tarsi 2 or 3 segmented. Hind wings are extended beyond the tegmina as a pair of processes. Special stridulatory organs are absent, but a humming sound is produced by the vibration of wings. A pair of tympanum is found under surface of the tibia. Ovipositor is vestigial. Gryllotalpa africana and Gryllotalpa is the example of the Gryllotalpidae family. These are the mole crickets which are found in the burrows in the land. They produce sound or a specific sound in the nature. So this is all about the families of order Orthoptera. Thank you. Thank you very much.